Hello, comic fans. Here's Earl Grey with another overview over a certain genre of European comics, or comic series to be precise. And last time I spoke about Wild Western comic series, and this time it will be all about crime slash detective espionage books. And this will be quite hefty video, as you can tell by the stacks that are piled up right in front of me, and these are not even all the books that I want to talk about. So let's get right into it. I have 13 ranks today, just because I want to include these books here, because I love them. I know they are not the greatest comics of all time, but really they are pretty silly fun. Die Draufgänger, the French original title is Les Casseurs, which means both daredevils and the destroyers. And this is, of course, pretty right. Just if you look by the look of the covers here. Christian Denayer, the artist behind the series, drew cars from early childhood on, and André Paul Duchateau knew about that, so he wrote him a story in which the cars and exploding cars are the main characters, actually. So they are really car freaks here at work. You can see the creators of this comic, the new prototype car. And it's totally whacked out, especially the first stories. Every two pages something's blowing up and crashing. They crash cars like other people drink or go to the toilet. This is really fun and but goofy and not too taken too seriously, and like it is with Rick Master, aka Ricochet, written by André Paul Duchateau as well. And Christian Denayer, the creator of Les Casseurs, even did some of the backgrounds for Ricochet, so there's no wonder that these comics have a bit of the same feel to them. The stories are sometimes really on the much too convenient side. So we have some villains who appear in several stories, and Rick Master, for incidentally, by chance, always crosses the path of some villains and murderers, and the solutions are not always very plausible, to say the least. But for whatever reason, I like these stories here that take me back to days when we just had three TV channels and watched as a family silly TV crime series like Derek or Streets of San Francisco or something like that. Streets of San Francisco is, by the way, a very apt comparison for Les Casseurs, the destroyers that I've shown you before. Now, on rank number 11, we have a comic that is very dear and close to my heart. I can't even tell you how important this comic here was for me as a kid. Drawn by the Italian Tacconi and written by one Castelli. Tacconi, Dylan Dog, he drew some episodes of Dylan Dog as well, but otherwise I don't have a clue about his further work. But yeah, this is a gang of, let's say, modern Robin Hoods, a group of people who represent more or less European national clichés, which makes it hard to digest from today's point of perspective, to be honest with you. So we have the seductive French woman, the Spanish or maybe Portuguese little thief, pocket thief, and He's not a European. Moose, the muscle of the man, the group, maybe Canadian or North American, I don't know. Kurt, the Swiss tech guy, and the English head of the group, even though he looks a bit like Stan Laurel, he is the brain of them all. But I loved, hands down, Kurt, the Swiss one, the most because of his funny innovations, who put which would put James Bond to shame here. So, really a fun series, even though some of the drawings and they all the guys look the same out of the panels. This is the typical Tacconi look from them, always so skew into the eye of the reader. But I loved the series very much. So now to the top 10 proper of my crime books here. Or this is actually an espionage book. Bruno Brasil. Drawn by the incomparable, fantastic William Vance. If you don't dig this classic, old-fashioned art style, yeah, William Vance won't do anything for you, but I love his stuff a lot. And this is very shortly, can be shortly described as James Bond as an American. And I wonder if you could call these comics James Bond comics, and I think you will miss Moneypenny and some of the characters, but overall it would feel the same to you. I'm talking about the old James Bond. Classic William Vance. These books are very beautiful. If you like the other series 13, maybe you can grab this by William Vance, espionage series by drawn by William Vance. You will probably like Bruno Brasil as well. Now to something different, even more classic. Jacques Martin's Le Franc. The French original title is Le Franc. And wait, here. But for whatever reason, they thought this name here is too difficult for German ears, so they changed it into this goofy title, L. Frank. El Frank. Yeah, this is a very cool title image, in my opinion. There are countless comics in Europe, I think, where we have the main hero and a boy as a as an sidekick, and sometimes the relationship between them is a bit goofy, like Batman Robin goofy, and not that he dons some kind of strange cape or something like that. He's the classic detective, but the sidekick thing here is always a bit strange. This comic here is very wordy, very classic in a way. Think of Blake and Mortimer wordiness, and you have the feel, and the drawings feel in the beginning. They have a strange beauty right from the start, but they are still a bit stereotype stuff, stiff a bit, especially if you compare it with his even very precise drawings later on. And this is really Ligne Claire at its best, and the stories are, yeah, if you have the time to read all the stuff, you have really a blast. these stories, I think. You don't have to expect to be surprised, because surprise is not in the book here, for the most part. Especially you have this typical thing here, Le Mystère Borg. There's already in the title, he has some arch enemy, Mr. Borg. Borg, yes. And I think he's a Swedish guy, and he always survives each story and appears in the next story. But this is not even a spoiler, because yeah, that's just the way these, at least the first stories, are constructed. This is only the first collected edition of a series of collected editions, and I really hope that this arch enemy doesn't appear too often. This was my rank number 9, and now to rank 8. And this is a series that bears the more or less funny German title Percy Pickwick. The original was called just Clifton, and this is Clifton, or Percy Pickwick. And he's the very, 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 very typical British detective, would I say, but he's more secret agent. So, and this story here is by far my favorite of them all. And Sieben Tage Angst, 7 days fear, or maybe a week of fear, however the story was called. In French, it was called 7 jours pour mourir, 7 days for dying. And as you can see, this is a Franco, well, it's a Belgian, I suppose, a Belgian comic, a funny comic, drawn in this funny style, but this is really action-packed, not in the beginning, but later on, it's really action-packed and gripping. Maybe I have to read it again, but I remember being very thrilled by the story here, which is funny if you look at these characters who just are funny cartoons in a way. So, almost like Les Casseurs a bit. And yeah, I've always enjoyed these comics here. You can get nowadays fancy hardcover editions of these comics, but I wouldn't change, think for now at least, my soft covers here, because yeah, I bought them over years and years and are fond of them. So, this seems to be very early incarnation of this, so you can see of Clifton, so you can see his origins in almost cartoony, funny comic ways of doing comics. So, Percy Pickwick, Percy Pickwick, Percy Pickwick, Clifton, Clifton, Clifton. On rank 7 we have Torpedo, a Spanish contribution to my list here, drawn by Jordi Bernet, and written by Sanjay Abouli. And this is, of course, very classic stuff, beautiful women, guys with no moral at all, and or their very own moral. More or less for adults and kids that feel already like adults. Fun stuff, very classic. If you can grab a black and white version of it, this won't hurt your reading pleasure, I would say, because the colors are not really necessary, maybe a bit. Here we have a black and white Torpedo comic, 1930, Torpedo 1936. It plays for sure in this old gangster milieu. And Jordi Bernet's drawings have a bit of the same appeal like this Argentinian José Muñoz, who I dig a lot. even though these are more pleasing for the eye, I think José Muñoz brings a lot more interesting experimentation to the table. So if I'm hard pressed, I would say I like José Muñoz a bit better. Now to rank 6, and this is Jackie Kotwitz. I could show you all my beautiful collected editions here, but I think this should be enough here. Drawn by Alain Daudier, and he has an interesting style, mixing of photo-referenced backgrounds. So he has a pretty realistic feel, but his main character has these cartoony features. So it reads like a good comic should do, but has this realistic gripping feel, and especially his dialogues are fantastic. Maybe the best example of realistic, funny, apt dialogues in comics overall. I really think this stuff here never feels wordy, even though if you look at these pages, you can maybe get the impression that here a bit of too much words are exchanged, but that's not the case. Especially the later comics of Jérôme K. Jérôme Bloch, the original French title of Jackie Kotwitz. The later ones are these that I would recommend for the most part. The first stuff that's available, the first few albums that are available in English are not as great as the later ones, just in my humble opinion. So, Jérôme K. Jérôme Bloch, my number 6, and now to my rank number 5, and a perfect example of that you should not judge a comic by its cover. Dylan Dog, an Italian fumetti, drawn by different artists who usually do a splendid job. The insides are drawn in a perfect, usually a more or less perfect black and white style, even though there are different styles and approaches to Dylan Dog, but they are usually very enjoyable in contrast with the covers. There is a bit of humor involved, for the most part, because of Dylan Dog's sidekick, who's modeled after Groucho Marx, and he is even called Groucho. And Dylan Dog always falls in love in each episode, and you know, when he falls in love with a lady, this won't end well for her, because each episode it's a different lady, and they all die in the end, or something gruesome happens to them. So here's a bit of horror involved as well. Dylan Dog is a detective for supernatural cases, for haunted houses or ghosts and mysterious, I don't want to say nonsense, but stuff like that. And if this is your cup of tea, you will enjoy it. And even though if this is not your cup of tea, Dylan Dog is a fantastic comic. No way around it. So, and now to rank number 4. And it's the Detective Hardy. I think you can guess what the English title, if there is maybe an English translation. Unfortunately, for most of the comics, in case I haven't said it, there is no English translation yet, but maybe I'm wrong, and you can give me the information about the obscure publishers who maybe have done an English translation. The French original title was Agence Hardy. She's this Detective Hardy. Written by the amazing Pierre Christine, who gave us Valerian and Loreline, and a lot of other fantastic comics. And drawn, and this is here. Yeah, this is just fantastic by the wonderful Annie Götzinger. I love her style. She had done much too few comics, in my opinion, and died too soon, of course. And this is just a shame. And she's really a loss for European comic culture. Very elegant style, fantastic stories. I know opinions differ. I saw other reviews, but I think the setting here and the Paris of a certain time, the politics involved, the politic background, as you can imagine with Pierre Christine, who is a very political interested guy, who leans a bit on the left side of politics, which doesn't hurt me too much. Yeah, you have all the characters involved in these comics here. Wonderful nostalgic comic. I'm as you may can guess by my choices and until now, I'm sometimes, or even more than just sometimes, pretty nostalgic guy and love this stuff here. So, and now to rank number three. And rank number three is, of course, the Nestor Burma series, drawn by the fantastic Jacques Tardy, after the pulp crime series written by Leo Mallet. And I'm pretty sure that a lot of the stuff here is already published in English by Fantagraphics. So you can get these series here, drawn in Jacques Tardy's typical cool style that you will dig totally when you read it. Maybe it has not this appeal if you open up the book, not of so much action, but a lot of classic finding the clues and solve the mystery stuff here. Nestor Burma is a fantastic adaptation of these crime stories from Leo Mallet. So, and this can just be topped by something exceptional. My rank number two is the aforementioned William Vance, written by Jean Van Am, and 13, an espionage thriller with crazy twists and turns. I did a video. Oh, I'm a bit afraid that this tome of books here, the stack of books, will tumble right in front of the cam. So it is a good thing that we can end this video. I did a video about 13, so check this out if you want to know about a bit more about this really European classic comic. And you can get some of the stuff in soft cover, even maybe shrunken down versions, I don't know, but you can get it in via Cinebook. And my rank number one is, of course, again, Jacques Tardy, Adele's Exceptional Adventures, a series of comics that is just mind-blowing, goofy, and capturing the atmosphere around 1900, when everything seemed to be possible. You have a bit of steampunkish goofiness and crazy monsters, a foreshadowing of the First World War sometimes. This is a downright interlude about the First World War, which is actually not a real Adele story. Here we have her again, revived ape humans. Really, I love these comics from the bottom of my heart, and there was no way to put this comic on some other rank than number one. He fools a lot around with us readers in throwing on a silly amount of characters into these stories, and on some pages in the first panel, the first person is killed. On the second panel, the killer is killed by a third person, and this third person is killed in the next panel, and so on and so on. And on the bottom corner, everyone is dead, or there are mummies flying around, and yeah. And still, there are some gripping stories to be told amongst that. And these comics are really a really wonder of comicdom. And no wonder that the movie adaptation of this thing here, to be fair, I haven't watched it, but I can't imagine that it encaptured just a bit of the fantastic, goofy silliness of these comics. So this was my overview of European comic series with crime, espionage, detective content. Yeah, you can expect a lot of more stuff to come, but since I'm actually moving, rearranging my books here a lot, it may can take a bit of time, but yeah, I think you will bear with me. Thanks a lot for watching and listening. Goodbye.